Welcome to our section on how to monitor activities in Microsoft Fabric. In a data analytics solution, you create, manage, and optimize the frameworks for collecting, storing, processing, and analyzing data. Data in its raw form isn't meaningful for making business decisions. Data with different sources has to be combined and loaded or ingested into data stores and transformed into formats that are useful for analysis. The ingestion and transformation process must be monitored so errors can be identified and remediated before they affect users. Microsoft Fabric provides capabilities for monitoring Fabric activities. In this module, we will explore how to use Monitor Hub to monitor ingestion and transformation activities in your Fabric environment, and how to use Activator to automatically take action when patterns or conditions are detected in changing data. In Fabric, you schedule activities and jobs that perform tasks like data movement and transformation. Activities have dependencies on one another. You need to make sure that the data arrives at its expected location on time and that system errors or delays don't affect users or downstream activities. End-to-end processes need to be managed to ensure they're reliable and performant and resilient. One aspect of this monitoring is identifying and handling long-running operations and errors effectively. By doing this, you can minimize downtime and quickly address any underlying issues. The following activities in Fabric allow you to perform tasks that deliver data to users. These activities should be monitored. Data pipelines. Monitor the success and failure of jobs and pipeline activities. Look for errors if the pipeline failed. View job history to compare current activity performance and past job execution performance to gain insight into errors were first introduced into the process. Data flows. Monitor start and end times, status, duration, and the load table activities. To investigate issues here, drill down into the activities and view information about errors. To monitor semantic model refreshes, monitor your refresh retries to help identify transient issues before classifying an issue as a failure. To monitor Spark jobs, notebooks, and lakehouses, monitor Spark job progress, task execution, resource usage, and review Spark logs. Lastly, to monitor Microsoft Fabric event streams, monitor stream event data, ingestion status, and integration performance. These are all good starting points for monitoring items in Fabric. Monitoring is the process of collecting system data and metrics that determine if a system is healthy and operating as expected. Monitoring exposes errors that occurred when they happened. To investigate issues and remediate errors, historical data is analyzed to get a picture of the health of the system or process. Continuously monitoring the data ingestion, transformation, and load processes to ensure that they're running smoothly. Consider also implementing some monitoring best practices, starting with identifying what to monitor and tracking metrics. Consider collecting and analyzing data on a regular basis to identify normal behavior so you can spot anomalies when they occur. Remember to review logs and metrics regularly to identify and establish parameters for normal system behavior. Also, take action to resolve problems when metrics and logs show deviations from the normal behavior. And lastly, optimize performance for monitoring data to identify bottlenecks or performance issues. Visualization tools make monitoring easier. They help you identify trends or anomalies. The Monitor Hub is the monitoring visualization tool in Microsoft Fabric. The Monitor Hub collects and aggregates data from selected Fabric items and processes. It stores Fabric activity data in a common interface so you can view the status of many different data integration, transformation, movement, and analysis activities in Fabric, all in one place, rather than having to monitor each separately. Some of the activities you can see in the Fabric monitor are data pipeline execution history, data flow executions, data mart and semantic model refreshes, Spark jobs and notebook execution history, and job details and more. The Monitor Hub can be opened by selecting Monitor from the Fabric navigation pane that's usually on the left. When you select View Detail, you can see the activity status, start and end time, duration, and activity statistics. To investigate what happened during an activity, some activities in the Monitor Hub include hyperlinks that allow you to drill down into the execution details. Information is provided about all errors and the successes and failure of an execution. Spark activities across items can also be viewed. You can also view Spark applications that were triggered from a notebook, Spark job definitions, and pipelines. When monitoring surfaces, changing data, anomalies, or critical events, alerts are generated or actions are triggered. Real-time data analytics is commonly based on the ingestion and processing of a data stream that consists of a perpetual series of data, typically related to specific point-in-time events. Real-time intelligence in Fabric contains a tool called Activator that can be used to trigger action on streaming data. For example, a stream of data from an environment, Internet of Thing weather sensor might be used to trigger emails to sailors when wind thresholds are met. When certain conditions or logic is met, an action is taken, like alerting users, executing a Fabric job item like a pipeline, or even kicking off Power Automate workflows. The logic can be either a defined threshold, a pattern like events happening repeatedly or over a time period of time, or the results of logic defined by Custo Query Language, a KQL query. Activator is a technology in Microsoft Fabric that enables automated processing of events that trigger actions. For example, you can use Activator to notify you by email when a value in an event stream deviates from a specific range, or to run a notebook to perform some Spark-based data processing logic when a real-time dashboard is updated. Activator operates based on four core concepts as shown here: events, objects, properties, and rules. Each record in a stream of data represents an event that has occurred at a specific point in time. The data in the event record can then be used to represent an object, such as a sales order, a sensor, or some other business entity. The fields in the event data can be mapped to properties of the business object, representing some aspects of its state. The key to using Activator is to automate actions based on events or to define rules that set conditions under which an action is triggered based on the property values of objects referenced in the events. Note all the conditions listed here on the right that it can be set to. For example, you might define a rule that takes an action that sends an email to a maintenance manager if the temperature measured by a sensor exceeds a specific threshold, as shown here on the right. Activator can help you in various scenarios, such as dynamic inventory management, real-time customer engagement, and effective resource allocation in a cloud environment. It's a potent tool for any circumstance that requires real-time data analysis and actions. Here are a few suggestions of when to use Activator. It can be used in initiating marketing actions when product sales drop, or to send notifications when temperature changes could affect perishable goods, or even to flag real-time issues affecting user experience on apps and websites, or to trigger alerts when a shipment hasn't been updated within an expected time frame, or to send alerts when a customer's account balance crosses a certain threshold, or to respond to anomalies or failures in data processing workflows immediately, or to run ads when the same store sales declines, or even to alert storage managers to move food from a failing grocery store freezer before it spoils. What are your use cases for Activator? Now let's see how to monitor Fabric activity in the Monitor Hub.
Now let's talk about how to monitor Fabric activity here in the Monitoring Hub. And this is really the central location for all of the monitoring activity in Fabric. So I've already created a workspace, as you can see right here. And what I'm going to do is make a lake house. So let me add a lake house that we can use to help monitor. And I'll give my lake house a name. And that will add that to the list there. So it'll take a moment. And you're going to see the lake house created, as you can see it right there. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to add data because there's no data here in my lake house. So I'm going to go into New Dataflow Gen 2. And from there, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new data flow. And notice here, I'm going to go ahead and change its name. And I'm going to call it, Receive Data. Then what we'll do is I'll go ahead and use this import a text CSV file. And what I'll do is I'm going to copy in a link to a file that I want to use here. And this is the file right here. So you can see you can get it off of GitHub. And what I'm going to do is use that as my link. Now, I've made a connection to it already to kind of test it out, but if you're doing this for the first time, of course, you're going to want to create a connection, use Anonymous as your authentication, and that should work for us. So I'll go ahead and pull that in. And it's going to take a moment here to connect to the data source. Here's what it's going to look like. So it's giving us a little bit of a preview of the data from that CSV file. And then I'm going to go ahead and click Create to make this. That will pull that data flow in for us. And then if I want to be able to use it, I'm going to go ahead and publish it. So the data flow has been created, but I wonder if it's done pulling in data. So I'm going to use Monitor, and we're going to see Monitor quite a lot here in this section. I'm going to refresh it so we can see it. And we'll look for it there in just a moment. So it should take just a bit to show up here. And I don't quite see it yet. There it is right there. So the received data, we should be able to see it here. There it is right there. It is currently in progress. So it's going out to that data source and pulling in the data for us through that data flow. And it's going to pull it into our products table there inside of, or make a products table even, inside of our lake house. So it'll take a moment to run. But notice there's other things that can be monitored from here. You can see if they ran. You can see their history, their capacity, all sorts of information about them if you'd like to add that in. But we'll wait here just a moment till this processes, and then we'll go out and see if we can see the data there in our lake house. So we'll give it just a moment. So I'm going to refresh it again, and it looks like it has succeeded. So it takes a little bit to actually run, and then once it's run, we're going to go hopefully and see what it's produced here in our lake house. I'm going to go ahead and refresh this. There you see the products table. And then if I click on it, you hopefully be able to see some of the records. So it just takes it a bit to kind of set things up. But this looks good, and it's going to hopefully give us a preview in a moment here. And there we go. So that central monitor hub can be used to monitor a lot of things. We saw it as the ability to be able to monitor a data flow, but we could use it also to monitor a notebook. So what I'm going to do So I'm going to go ahead and create a new notebook. And I'm going to make certain that we can get connected to our Lakehouse source there. So I'm going to refresh all resources there. And I'm going to, in this notebook, create a query. I'm going to give this a name too. So we have notebook one. I think that's good right now. We'll know notebook one. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a query right here from our products table to do a load data through Spark. Then I'm going to go ahead and run this. So we'll get that going. Our notebook is running right now. And then I'm going to go out and I'm going to take a look at our monitor and see if we can see that process. Now, hang on, we're going to wait for it to finish real quick. But notice that it is going to take it a little bit of time to kind of start the Spark session. And then after it starts that Spark session, then we will get some result from it. And then we'll go see what it looks like in the monitor. Okay, so that looks good. I'm going to go out to the monitor and see if I see notebook one out there. And there it is right there. So it looks like it's in process. And we can see it right there. So the monitor can be used to really pick up a lot of data, as you can tell. And we'll refresh this in a little bit here. See if we see it. Finish up its status. I want you to note, too, that while we're in here, we can do some filtering if we'd like. So maybe what we want to do is see some of the runs that kind of filter things out. We can do that very easily with this. But what I'll do here is I'm going to go into more options here, and you can see historical runs. You can also view detail on it. So there's some of the detail of the last run there that we had with received data. Gives us that it succeeded, its start time, its end time, its duration, actually ran really fast. And then we can also go in there again and take a closer look even at the historic runs. So if it's run a couple times, you'd be able to see it here. And so you have a lot of little places you can go to get extra information, really to just see how things are running under the covers here inside of Fabric. And I can also go in here and do a little bit of filtering. So I'm going to go back to my main view. Let me refresh that again and see if I get notebook one to kind of succeed there. It'll take a moment, I guess. But I can come up to the filter option here, and maybe I want to see my whole list of those that have succeeded. Maybe I'm also really interested in those that have failed. That would be a good one. Now, some of these ran a while ago, but you see some that have failed. And maybe we want to blend those in. So you have the ability to kind of work with this here, the status. I can also adjust the item. So what exactly I'm looking for. I could look for the start time. I'm going to go ahead and pick up the Dataflow Genflow there and see how that kind of weans down the list here. I can sort it by start time, when it who it submitted by. I can put a person's name in there with a location. So you have a lot of options there to filter it. And then you can also add and remove fields. So there's fields that you can add to this list if you like to do that. Maybe I want to know a little bit more about maybe the downstream run. Maybe I don't need the capacity right now. And then notice I can scroll off to the right and get extra information on each of my Dataflow Gen 2 options here. So as you can see, there's a lot you can do with Monitor. And this is just really touching the tip of the iceberg. So I hope this helped a bit. I want you to come in here and explore. And I want to say also, I will see you in the next section. See you soon.
In this section, we looked at how to monitor different Fabric activities in Fabric and its best practices using the Monitor Hub. We also took a closer look at what is Activator, its features and use cases. For more information on how to monitor activities in Microsoft Fabric, please see the link shown here.